Let's rewind to a couple of workdays in June. I'm Victoria and I work in an office here in Oslo, Norway. So let's start off with my morning routine. I like to keep my mornings as simple as possible so I can focus on getting ready and heading out the door. That means I usually wash my hair the night before or go with a sleek ponytail, and I always plan my outfit ahead so I don't have to spend energy deciding in the morning. My hair was kind of wavy from sleeping with a braid, so today I decided to go with a high ponytail and I brushed out a few pieces to keep it looking a bit softer and less polished than my usual style. Another thing I prep the night before an office day is my iced latte. I make a double espresso, add a splash of vanilla syrup and sweetener, add the milk and pop it in the fridge overnight in a glass. People sometimes ask if it tastes weird making it ahead, but after years of doing it both ways, I can confidently say there's no difference in taste. Or at least, I think so. I just don't store it in my Stanley tumbler overnight. I feel like that might affect the taste and be harder to clean, but that's just my guess. So now I add a few ice cubes into the tumbler to make the iced latte extra cold and nice. And the tumbler keeps the ice cubes frozen for so long, almost the entire day. But I usually finish my iced latte within the first hour or so. But all I'm saying is that this tumbler is so effective. My commute is pretty quick. The metro gets me into the city center in about 13 minutes. So door to door, it's only around 25 minutes to the office. The metro in Oslo is super reliable, unlike the regional trains, which seem to have issues a few days every week. My coworkers who commute from outside Oslo always have something to say about it. Because of this, I could never see myself moving out of Oslo and relying on the trains. I know how frustrating I can get when I can't get home on time. So if you're considering living in the areas outside of Oslo while working in Oslo, that's something to think about. It's not common for people to drive into the city center for work either, due to heavy traffic and limited parking. Anyway, I work at my computer for a few hours and then it's time for lunch. At lunchtime, we all head down to the cafeteria to eat together, whether we brought food from home or are buying something there. I usually bring a packed lunch that I prepare the night before, and that's what I did today. Occasionally though, I'll pick up something from a nearby cafe or a grocery store, but bringing my own lunch is always the most budget-friendly choice. One of my favorite go-to lunches is a potato wrap with what we call italiensk salat here in Norway, which translates to Italian salad. I don't think it's actually Italian though, it's just a name we use. The salad is essentially a creamy mayonnaise-based spread with shredded cabbage and carrots, typically used on sandwiches. I like to add grilled chicken pieces and red bell peppers. It's super simple to make and so delicious. After lunch, it was back to work. We had a company celebration today, so there were fruit and cupcakes. It was a nice little treat to brighten the day. I also had a couple of team meetings afterward. After work, my colleague and I went grocery shopping together at a great international market on Storgata. They have incredibly affordable fruits and vegetables. I should really shop here more often. But here, I was struggling to find a ripe mango. Anyway, the prices here are so much better than the regular chains like Kiwi, Rema, Extra and so on. The only downside is carrying a heavy backpack home on the metro, which is why I don't always go. But if you ever need a specialty ingredient for international cooking, you can always count on this store to have it. Like when I was trying out that Turkish dish, çilbir, which I tried out in another video, I went to this store to get the spice called pul biber. I could browse the aisles in here forever. I bought two mangoes today. I was planning on having one for dessert today, but I don't think they are ready yet. They are a bit hard, so I think I have to wait until tomorrow maybe. I actually bought two mangoes on Monday and I ate one on Monday and then the other one on Tuesday. But no mango today, I guess. But
I'm so addicted to mangoes right now. It's so good. And it also helps me to stay away from chocolate and candy and sweets and stuff. Guess I have to wait until tomorrow or maybe Friday. Yeah, we'll see. I am starting to get a bit hungry, so I think I'm gonna start dinner right away. But I need to check if this yogurt is okay, because I'm gonna make tzatziki. But this has been opened for a few weeks now, so I don't know if it's okay or not. It smells okay, but oh, it has separated a bit, so please don't spill. It smells okay, but I guess I should taste it. Yeah, I think it's okay. So, okay, let's make dinner. Today, I'm making a Greek-inspired dish. I'm not sure if it fully qualifies as gyro, but that's the inspiration. Just a super simple and quick version. It's perfect for days when I don't want to cook for too long. I just whip up some homemade tzatziki and chop up a few veggies. I like cucumber, tomato, and usually onion, though we didn't have any today. I use pork and add a bit of dried rosemary for extra flavor. I also heat up some pita bread, which tastes super fresh and so good. And of course, I can't forget the feta cheese. Like I said, a super simple and delicious dinner. So this is the dress I picked up. I'm a bit torn because I really like it. I think it's so cute, so beautiful, but there are some things I don't like. I don't know, maybe I'm a bit like picky, but I think you kind of should be picky with your money and what you spend them on. Okay, let me explain or show you. I feel like for that price, it should have like a certain kind of quality, a standard. I don't know if it shows now because I just ironed it, but I think it was this color. It kind of bends downwards, but I think I was able to iron it out, so it looks better now, so maybe it's not a problem. But then there's the other thing which kind of annoys me, so I'm just picking my dress up here. I don't know if you can see it, but the stitching is really bad. Part here doesn't match properly with this part here, so it looks kind of weird. I think you can see it better from the inside. It's just very off, and that annoys me because I feel like the work is very cheap, it's cheaply done, so I really want to keep it, but at the same time I don't know if I should. Will this thing continue to bother me? But I'm gonna contact customer service and then see what I'm gonna do. It's such a pretty dress. It's a new day, the day after, and I'm heading into the office again. My morning routine is pretty much the same. I'm still making my coffee, but today I didn't pack a lunch. I felt like trying something different, which you will see come lunchtime. I think June is my favorite month in Norway, or at least in the top three. The days are warm by Norwegian standards, and we get the most daylight each day. On this particular day I'm filming, Thursday, June 20th. It's actually the summer solstice, our longest day of the year. After this, each day gets a bit darker and shorter until December, when the sun turns back on the 21st. But we don't really notice the shorter days until maybe around September. Alright, let's head to the office. The reason I carry both a purse and a backpack is because I bring my laptop back and forth every day, and my shoulders would be wrecked if I tried to fit everything into a single large purse. My smaller purse is just for easy access to essentials like my phone, wallet and keys, and also my camera when I'm filming. It's also handy if I go out for lunch, so I don't need to bring my whole backpack along since that stays in the office. I'm usually one of the first to arrive at the office, getting in around 7:30, while most people don't come until 8. One of the perks of summer at my workplace, which isn't common at every company, is something called summertime. So from mid-May to mid-September, we can work 30 minutes less each day without a pay cut. I still take my 30-minute unpaid lunch break. I need it, but coming in at 7:30 means I can head home by 3. I really love that about my job. For lunch, I bought a Simit at Backstube. It's kind of like a bagel and it's delicious. It's with ham and cheese, tomato, cucumber and lettuce. And on warm days, we like to eat outside on the rooftop terrace at our office. It's so nice to sit outside during our lunch break. Tonight, I decided to make Vietnamese spring rolls or summer rolls for dinner. I filled rice paper with crisp lettuce, rice noodles, cucumber, prawns, fresh cilantro, and mint leaves. I was introduced to this dish about 2 years ago by a Vietnamese friend when I had dinner at her place. Since then, I've been obsessed with it. There's just something irresistible about the combination of fresh flavors, especially when paired with a rich peanut and hoisin dipping sauce. But my partner is not really a fan of this dish. I usually only make it when I'm alone, like if he's working late or something. For the dip, I start with peanut butter and hot water, then I blend in a pack of hoisin wok sauce. This is a recipe I came up with when I wanted a lighter, lower calorie option. The wok sauce has fewer calories than traditional hoisin and gives a smoother, more liquid consistency. I also add a splash of sweet chili sauce and a squeeze of fresh lemon or lime juice to balance the flavors. So that's it! It's simple, flavorful, and absolutely delicious. Later in the evening, I decided to head to the nearby shopping center to browse a bit and pick up a few things at the grocery store. Thank you.
My partner called and decided to join me, so we spent some time browsing the shops together. Okay, I think I'm gonna end the vlog here. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please give it a like. That will make me so happy, and hopefully I will see you in my next video. Bye!